What if I told you that not eating for 72 hours and just drinking water could help you burn fat, boost energy, reset your blood sugar, and even trigger anti-aging processes in your body? Now, it might sound extreme, but your body is actually designed to fast. And once you hit a certain point, especially after 40, when everything from weight loss to energy levels feels harder, something really powerful starts to happen behind the scenes. We're talking about deep fat burning, hormone balancing, and cellular cleanup your body wants to do, but rarely has the chance. Now, I'm not here to push a crazy detox or a dangerous challenge. This is about understanding exactly what happens, hour by hour, when you give your body a break from food and just drink water for 72 hours. We're going to talk about what to expect when you fast, when the hunger will fade, when fat burning kicks in, and how to fast safely, especially if you're over 40 and you want to do it right. So let's break it all down, because once you know what's happening in each phase, it becomes a lot easier to get through it and actually enjoy the results. I'm Kait, a nutritionist who specializes in insulin resistance and blood sugar health. I have helped hundreds of clients over 40 who feel like their body just isn't responding the way it used to. I have helped clients to reverse prediabetes, lose stubborn weight, and get their energy back using simple, science-backed strategies. And fasting is one of the tools I often use. Now, this video isn't medical advice. I'm just here to share what happens to your body when you go 72 hours just drinking water. And what we're talking about today is backed by research. And if you're not quite ready to dive into a 72-hour fast, I'll talk about different approaches you can try instead. So let's start off by talking about why anyone would voluntarily not eat for 72 hours. Well, the truth is that fasting is one of the most powerful tools we have to reset our metabolism, especially as we get older. After 40, things like stubborn belly fat, low energy, and poor sleep aren't just annoying. They're signs that your metabolism might be slowing down and your cells aren't functioning as efficiently as they used to. And here's where water fasting becomes interesting. When you stop eating for a long period of time, and I mean a real fast, not just skipping breakfast, you give your body the space it needs to switch from constantly digesting food to finally getting some serious repair work done. This includes things like lowering insulin, which is crucial for fat burning and improving insulin sensitivity. It includes increasing human growth hormone, which helps preserve muscle and boosts our recovery. And the big one is it triggers and boosts autophagy higher than anything else. And autophagy is your body's natural way of cleaning out damaged cells. Now, if you've seen my video on what stops autophagy when you're fasting, you're probably at least a little bit familiar with this topic. Autophagy is always happening to some degree in the body, and things like exercise and eating a low-carb diet can increase it as well. But it really ramps up after the 24 to 36 hour mark of fasting. And by 72 hours, you're in deep cellular cleanup mode. And this is especially important if you're trying to fight inflammation or support healthy aging. Water fasting also drastically improves insulin sensitivity. And that is something I'm talking about all the time on my channel, is ways to improve this because the vast majority of the population is insulin resistant to some degree. And we do become more insulin resistant naturally later in life. So if we had any level of insulin resistance beforehand, then it just compounds. And that's why fasting is so beneficial for this demographic. And if weight loss is your goal, here's another benefit. When you're fasting, you're burning your own body fat for fuel. No extra snacks, no protein bars, just stored energy finally being put to use. But here's something important to keep in mind. This type of fast isn't to be used as a punishment. It's not a detox gimmick or some trendy diet hack. It's simply a biological switch, something your body was designed to do when food wasn't available. The problem today is that food is always available. We spend most of our day in a fed state, and we rarely spend any time besides when we're sleeping in a fasted one. For good metabolic health, we need to have a balance of the two. Water fasting, when done right and safely, gives your body that break. And the benefits? They go way beyond weight loss. We're talking improved brain function, reduced inflammation, better immune health, and even potential anti-aging effects. There's some fascinating research, including studies by Dr. Walter Longo, that show that prolonged fasting can actually stimulate the regeneration of immune cells through stem cellular activation. And that is huge, especially as we get older. And for anyone dealing with emotional eating or constant cravings, fasting can also reset your relationship with food. By stepping away from constant meals and snacks, you start to understand what true hunger feels like, and more importantly, What isn't hunger? So if you're over 40 and you feel like your metabolism has hit a wall, water fasting just might be the key. It might be the metabolic reset you didn't know you needed. So let's talk about what exactly happens to your body hour by hour when you're fasting. The changes in hormones, energy, fat burning, hunger, and even your mood. Fasting isn't always easy, but when you know what to expect and when it's happening, it gets a whole lot more doable. So let's get into the timeline with phase one, and this is 0 to 12 hours. When you first start your fast, your body is simply doing what it does between meals, burning through the glucose currently circulating in your bloodstream, and then tapping into glycogen reserves stored in your liver and muscles. You're still very much running on sugar at this point, which means you're not in fat burning mode yet. Now, you might feel hungry around your usual meal times, and that's because our body anticipates when we're gonna eat and it releases hormones responsible for digestion. And that's why even if we're not truly hungry, we get cravings around the same time every day. It's not because your body truly needs food, but because of a habit and the hormone ghrelin. This hormone spikes based on your eating routine. And this is when electrolytes start to matter. As your body burns through glycogen, it also releases water, and with it, important minerals like sodium, potassium, and magnesium. This can lead to feeling fatigued, dizziness, headaches, and even muscle cramps. Yes, these can be caused by a sugar crash, but they can also be caused by a salt crash. And that's why I always recommend adding a pinch of sea salt to your water or using an electrolyte mix without added sugar. And if you've done my 3-day blood sugar reset, you'll know just how essential this tip is. Honestly, supplementing electrolytes at this time can make or break your results. But now let's move on to phase two, and that's between 12 to 24 hours. This is when things start to shift. As insulin levels continue to fall, your body begins transitioning from burning glucose to burning fat for fuel. This is a key metabolic switch, and it's where water fasting starts really working its magic. Now, if you've done intermittent fasting before, this will feel familiar. Around the 16 to 20 hour mark, you may feel a bit foggy or sluggish, and that's your body adjusting. It's transitioning to using fat and ketones for energy instead of sugar. Hormones like glucagon start rising, which helps release stored fat from your cells and provides steady energy. And at this time, your metabolism actually increases slightly, not decreases, like a lot of people think. Continue to support your body with electrolytes here, because as insulin drops, you retain less water and lose electrolytes as well. And this is when dehydration symptoms can sneak in, a dry mouth, fatigue, or dizziness. And now onto phase three, which is the 24 to 36 hour mark. By now, you're probably officially in ketosis, to some level at least. Your liver is producing ketones, which your brain and body begin using as a clean, efficient fuel source. And this is when many people start to feel clearer, more focused, and surprisingly even-tempered. And what's amazing is that hunger actually starts to decrease during this phase. And that's because ketones actually suppress appetite. You might even forget it's lunchtime. Meanwhile, your body ramps up growth hormone, which can increase up to 5 times during prolonged fasting. This protects your muscle mass and boosts fat breakdown. So no, you're not automatically losing muscle when you're fasting. Your body doesn't want to burn through your muscle, it wants to preserve it. Now, some other things to be aware of during this time that you might not expect. You might feel colder and you might notice your heart rate decreases. This is your body downshifting into repair mode, conserving energy while it gets to work on healing processes. So don't panic if your energy dips a little bit at this time. This is normal. A warm cup of salt water can help. And now phase four, 36 to 48 hours. This is the deep clean phase. And if you've made it this far, kudos to you. Your body has now moved into full-blown autophagy, the process of breaking down and recycling old damaged cells. You may experience moments of deep mental clarity or calm, almost a meditative state. Many people describe this phase as feeling emotionally balanced and internally quiet, and that's not your imagination. Ketones have a direct calming effect on the brain. And because your digestive system is taking a break, you're not gonna be bloated, you're not gonna be gassy, no sluggish digestion, no energy being wasted on breaking down food, your entire GI tract is getting a much needed break. And again, hydration and electrolytes are key here. As your cells flush out waste, your body uses minerals to fuel that process. So make sure you're staying on top of your sodium, magnesium, and potassium. Otherwise, you might hit a wall. And finally, we have phase five, which is between 48 to 72 hours. Now we are at the peak of our fast. And again, if you've made it this far, huge congratulations. Your ketone levels are gonna be at their highest and insulin at its lowest. Your body is deep into a healing, fat-burning, and anti-inflammation state. And this is when research suggests our immune system starts to regenerate. According to Dr. Walter Longo's studies, extended fasting can trigger stem cell production, especially in white blood cells, effectively renewing parts of your immune system. And this is incredible, especially after 40, because this is when our immune system starts to decline. Inflammation markers drop, fat burning continues, and you may experience a natural mood lift or even a sense of euphoria. And this isn't a coincidence. Again, it comes back to ketones. Now, a lot of people, once they get to this point, they feel like they could go forever. And while that's a good sign your fast has gone well, it's important to not push it. The 72-hour mark is when a lot of the benefits peak. And now is a good time to transition out of the fasted state. So let's talk about how to break your fast properly. Because if you go straight into a binge, you're gonna actually take away from a lot of the benefits you worked so hard for. After 72 hours of not eating, your digestive system has slowed down significantly. Your stomach isn't producing as much acid, and your pancreas has downregulated enzyme production. So throwing in a big meal at this time will likely lead to bloating, nausea, and digestive distress. Instead, you want to break your fast with bone broth. This is a great source of minerals, and it's gentle on digestion. About an hour later, you want to have a light meal that's high in quality protein, like poached eggs or white fish. You can also add in a few cooked vegetables at this time, but avoid anything raw, like kale or broccoli, anything that's fried, or large amounts of dairy or refined carbohydrates. Even high sugar fruit can be a lot if you have it right away. And don't forget to chew slowly. This simple habit gives your digestive enzymes time to catch up and helps your body adjust back to eating mode. So fasting is powerful, but not everyone should jump straight into a 72-hour fast. If you're pregnant or breastfeeding, if you're underweight or have a history of disordered eating, or if you're taking any medications for blood sugar or blood pressure, please do not attempt a fast without medical supervision. Fasting can rapidly impact these conditions, especially blood sugar. Your need for blood sugar lowering medications will decrease rapidly, so if you're still taking them, this can be dangerous. It's important to monitor your blood sugar closely during this time. Also, people with adrenal issues, high chronic stress, thyroid disorders, or irregular heart rhythms should also proceed cautiously. If you're new to fasting, it's best to build up slowly. Start with a daily fasting routine of 12 to 16 hours every day. This will help to strengthen your fasting muscle. And then you can extend to 24, 36, 48, and eventually 72 hours after time. Now, a 72-hour fast is not something you need to do weekly or even monthly. For most people, every 2 to 3 months is the sweet spot to maximize the benefits without overstressing your body. Because yes, fasting is a stressor, but it's an acute stressor. If you're fasting too regularly for too long, this causes chronic stress, which is not what we want. Fasting should be looked at like a tool in your toolkit, not your only strategy. It needs to be combined with quality sleep, proper hydration, movement, and a low insulin diet. All of this together and your results will multiply. So let's do a quick recap. At the 0 to 12 hour mark, you're going to be burning glucose and adjusting to not eating. 12 to 24 hours, this is when your insulin drops and fat burning begins. 24 to 36 hours, you enter ketosis, your brain feels clearer and hunger drops. 36 to 48 hours, autophagy is in full swing and deep cell cleanup mode begins. And then 48 to 72 hours is peak healing, fat burning, and possible even immune regeneration. So if you're over 40 and feeling a little bit stuck, give a 72-hour fast a try. But remember, if you've never done any intermittent fasting before, it's best not to jump straight in. Start with daily intermittent fasting, 12 to 16 hours, and then throw in a 24-hour fast once you've gotten used to that. Work your way up to 72 hours. But remember, it doesn't have to be all or nothing. Even if you can't make it to that 72-hour mark, you're still gonna get a lot of benefits. So don't put too much pressure on yourself. And always remember to stay hydrated, because this can absolutely transform your fasting experience from miserable to manageable. Now, I wanna hear from you guys. Have you tried a 72-hour fast before? When did you find the hunger stopped? I wanna hear from you guys in the comments down below. Thank you guys so much for watching, and I'll see you in the next one. Bye.